Before diving more deeply into the modeling and verification process of our connected cars data, let us take a detour and think about the various models that we have talked about in the previous lessons. In models in natural sciences, many simplifying assumptions are made about the system under investigation, so that it is possible to arrive at some mathematical expression of the phenomenon. This gives us a way of understanding the phenomenon and modeling the observed data in light of this fundamental understanding. Complexity is often introduced as additional layers in terms of perturbations or dissipative effects.
We will start looking at how to split the data. Before we do so, let's investigate what are the characteristics of models. We just talked about mathematical models, such as what are used in the natural sciences, economics, medicine, etc. Part of what we do in natural sciences or mathematical models involves point estimation. That is to calculate the value of certain quantity very, very well. Sometimes we might have a multi-parameter model and we want to make a good fit to the parameters. Often the generalization of the model is inherently built into the model. The immediate goal of such a model is to fit the data as best as possible with the underlying assumption that the mathematical structure of the model in itself helps to make the model generally applicable. On the other hand, we have data-driven models. These are models used in statistical and machine learning techniques, and they have very wide applicability in sciences, engineering, computer science, etc. In this case, we train on data from a very complex phenomenon, and the generalization to new data from similar phenomenon needs to be explicit, understanding. So you see, the simplifying assumptions in your model for the data-driven case aids in computation, whereas the simplified assumptions in a mathematical model aids in understanding of the basic phenomenon. The goal in the data-driven models is to learn the underlying patterns of the phenomenon directly from the data using appropriate algorithms. These algorithms are then tuned so that they're useful in general towards solving similar problems. In most cases, we want to make sure that the model is not overtrained on the data and does not overfit the training data, but also generalize to new data.